All of our previous stories led into this moment, building this first chapter we now bring to a close by opening our arms out to the world to bring us all in, across our communities, the diaspora, and the world to celebrate unity and culture. But also, the one common experience we all have, being desired for your culture, never being told that you belong, but still showing up to do the work, from dusk till dawn. That is what James Whitner, the founder of the Whitaker Group, which includes A Ma Maniere, Social Status, as well as APB, that's what he said about his upcoming collaboration with Jordan Brand, which consists of two Jordan 5s, my favorite silhouette, one dusk, one dawn, and as a BSD, a black sneaker defender. They did it again. A Ma Maniere, Air Jordan 5, Dusk. Now, this shoe is dropping on November 24th for $225. It is very expensive, but that is pretty common with A Ma Maniere releases. They tend to go for a more elevated, more premium aesthetic. And this shoe is one pair out of two Jordan 5s that's part of the same campaign. And this one, it is the Dusk colorway. Now, I don't know if I like this one over the Dawn colorway. I think they're both really, really nice. And as a Jordan 5 sucker, that is my favorite Jordan shoe ever. I can't choose. I don't have those in hand yet, so I can't make like an in-hand comparison, but if I had to choose, even as a black sneaker defender, I think there's something about that Dawn colorway that is just really nice. But honestly, you can't go wrong. And this release is part of the Slowly Rise campaign from A Ma Maniere. So if you know anything about A Ma Maniere collaborations with Jordan Brand, they always come out with like a very dedicated and thought out detailed campaign to go along with their releases. So oftentimes they'll use like a short video that comes out with the campaign. This one, it is called the Still We Rise campaign, based on Maya Angelou's Still I Rise poem, as well as James Baldwin's writing, specifically the to be African American is to be African without any memory and to be American without any privilege. And the Jordan 5s originally released in 1990 for a price of $125, which is around a whopping price of $310 in 2023. And it is designed by legendary designer Tinker Hatfield. This shoe was inspired by a World War II Mustang fighter plane. I believe that was the official name. And that plane resembled a shark. It's also made to resemble Michael Jordan's biting style, according to Nike.com. So that's where you see that very distinct feature of the Jordan 5. Very distinct aesthetic, the shark teeth on the midsole. That is my favorite part about the Jordan 5. When this Jordan 5 Burgundy retroed again this year, a lot of people thought, why wouldn't this be the A Ma Maniere Jordan 5? This shoe, this colorway actually came out way back in 2007. So I don't think it would have made too much sense just to stick like an A Ma Maniere logo on this shoe. And believe it or not, I actually really like this shoe. I really like this colorway. As nice as this is, I don't think it's a clear winner. I don't think it's a clear winner. Let me know which one you would choose. In the upper sole of the shoe, it is nubuck. I know a lot of websites, including A Ma Maniere's own website, states that it's suede. However, I'm 99% sure it's nubuck. I know they're all forms of leather. However, the nubuck on this shoe, it's super nice. It's very smooth, very soft. Now, the Jordan 5 usually does come with a lace lock. It's the first Jordan shoe to use a lace lock, by the way. I don't have that on me because I always take the lace locks off. I never wear it. It just gets in the way. But obviously it does come with a lace lock, and it also replaces the Jumpman that you see on non-OG colorways. It replaces it with Nike. And this Jordan 5, again, A Ma Maniere is very good at details and storytelling. The netting that you usually see on the Jordan 5 has been slightly altered. So you actually see the A Ma Maniere logo, specifically that A that makes up the netting on the side of the shoe, as well as going up the tongue. It is pre-aged, which I don't really love. I get that it goes with the outsole, but I don't really love that pre-aged color. However, the netting on Jordan 5s over time, it yellows anyway, so I don't really mind it too much. But overall, if I had to choose just out of the box, I do prefer white netting, but just the attention to details, changing that up, branding it, I think it's a really cool idea. I'm a sucker for storytelling. And then speaking of the tongue, this does come with a 3M tongue, a slightly slimmed down version of the tongue, and it is mismatched tongues. On this shoe, it does have the A Ma Maniere logo. On the other one, it has the Jumpman, just like you see on normal Jordan 5s. And one thing to note about the 3M tongues on Jordan 5s, some of them come really stiff. They dig into your ankles. One that comes to mind immediately in my rotation, it is the Jordan 5 Low Clot. That one really digs into my ankles even after I broke them in. This one, I don't feel that same problem. And fun fact, the Jordan 5 is actually the first Jordan shoe to use 3M on their shoe. But only two OG colorways use the 3M material on the tongue. And inside the tongue, even the stitching is branded, so you see A Ma Maniere's logo all over. The stitching on the ankle collar is also branded. And on one shoe, the tag of the tongue says A Ma Maniere. The other one has Michael Jordan, the GOAT signature. And again, the attention to detail, just the fact that they changed up the stitching on the inside of the tongue. Gotta give them credit. And on the heel of the shoe, you see this very subtle DBoss 23. Now, not all Jordan 5s nowadays come with that 23. Actually, when Jordan 5s first released in 1990, only one OG colorway had the 23. That was the Fire Reds. And through time, some of the Jordan 5s come with 23. Some of them don't. I don't quite know how they decide which ones to include with the 23. But A Ma Maniere, they usually get special treatment. And speaking of special treatment, on the booty of the shoe, this Jordan 5 comes with Nike Air branding, and usually for non-OG colorways, it comes with a Jumpman. A Ma Maniere breaks all the rules, they get Nike Air booty treatment. And the ankle collar of this Jordan 5 is also slimmed down, so a lot of people complain about how bulky the Jordan 5s are. I don't really have that complaint. The Jordan 5 is my favorite silhouette. However, I don't mind when they slim this down as well. I think the most recent Jordan 5 they did this for was the DJ Khaled We The Best Jordan 5s, both colorways. For me, I don't really care. I'm just a Jordan 5 sucker. And speaking of the ankle collar, I thought they would have gone with like a kilted lining around the ankle collar. A lot of A Ma Maniere shoes do that to go for a more premium and luxurious aesthetic. This shoe doesn't. It doesn't really make a difference for me. I don't have a preference as long as the shoe looks good. And I think even without that kilted lining, the shoe looks great. And the insole of the shoe, I did actually expect mismatched insoles. However, this shoe does come with just Nike Air on the insole. But again, the attention to detail. This insole actually has an embroidered Nike Air. So usually for most Jordan shoes, you just see like a printed Nike Air or a Jumpman on it. This one, it's stitched, it's embroidered. And probably my favorite thing about the Jordan 5, it is that sharp teeth on the midsole. This one comes in that burgundy color. I think that just looks awesome. I love that burgundy. They really did strike like the lottery with this burgundy. That's like a cheat code. You put this burgundy on a ton of shoes, and it just elevates it. It just looks so elegant. It looks more premium. You just can't go wrong with that color. And the Jordan 5s does come with a polyurethane midsole with obviously a visible Nike Air unit on the heel. And again, more storytelling. On this visible Air unit, you can see A Ma Maniere. I'm not quite sure I love that. I think it's a bit too much branding. I kind of do prefer if I could just see into it. But A Ma Maniere does what A Ma Maniere wants. And this Jordan 5 does come with a rubber outsole. It is a translucent, aged, pre-aged yellow outsole. I don't love that color. Overall, I do just prefer if this is white, if the netting was white as well. I just think this kind of looks dirty. I get it, the aged aesthetic and vintage aesthetic is something they do quite regularly, and it's just used very commonly for all Jordan brand shoes now. But yeah, if there's one thing that I don't love, it's that aged, pre-aged outsole. It just is a bit too yellow for me. The netting isn't as yellow, but this outsole is very, very yellow. And again, the left and right shoe is mismatched branding. So this one has Jumpman. The other one has an A Ma Maniere logo on the outsole. And this outsole that it cut out is Nike instead of Jordan. So essentially on this shoe, they've replaced the Jumpman and Jordan on non-OG colorways that you usually see with Nike. So this one has Nike, just like an OG. Booty of the shoe has Nike Air, just like an OG. The insoles has Nike Air, just like an OG. They basically treated this like an OG colorway. And another fun fact, the Jordan 5 was the first Jordan shoe to use clear translucent outsoles, and what a great trend that they started. And this shoe does come with two extra set of laces, one in white, one in sail. And this is one of those times, one of the rare times that I think it's a very easy choice between extra laces or the laces that come out of the box. I'm going with the extra laces. I think whether it's the white or the sail laces, I think it really gives this shoe a different look. It really makes it pop. If I had to choose out of those two, probably sail, because they already pre-aged like a lot of the shoe. So maybe sail makes more sense, but I think the white looks really, really nice as well. Let me know which one you would choose in the comments below. Box of the shoe, just like you would expect from A Ma Maniere, a branded burgundy box. A Ma Maniere paper inside, and a very cool kind of pixelated image inside the lid. Now, in terms of sizing and comfort, I'm a wide footer and I do just go true to size for Jordan 5s. And the Jordan 5, I'm happy to say, it is my favorite shoe in terms of comfort from Jordan 1 to 14. It is just so comfortable. I know it's bulky. I know it might look very heavy. It's actually lighter than it looks with the polyurethane midsole. It does have some weight savings to it compared to like a rubber cup sole. Even though the ankle collar is slightly slimmed down, I think practically I don't feel too much of a difference in terms of how my ankle feels. However, with the bulky Jordan 5 ankle collar, I do like kind of squeezing that part. It just feels very soft. This one, you don't really feel it as much. And if you don't wear high enough socks, maybe this thinner part might slice into your ankles over time, but you can easily solve that. Just wear proper socks Everything else, the padding inside, the snugness, it just fits my wide feet really well. So whether or not you have wide feet, I do recommend just going true to size. Now cushioning wise, it is an old shoe. It just has a polyurethane midsole with a Nike Air unit on the heel. So it's not the most advanced technology. So if you're into that very soft feeling on modern day shoes, maybe this isn't for you. For me, the cushioning of the Jordan 5 is perfect. I have bad knees, I have a bad back. So a flatter feel to the ground is slightly more preferred. I think it really does strike the right balance. And that brings the total sole score of the Jordan 5 A Ma Maniere Dusk to 44 out of 50. A very high score compared to other collaborations. Now first up, it is colorway. I am a black sneaker defender. I like black sneakers. I love black sneakers more than a lot of people. So this colorway was kind of made for me. The one nitpick I have is this yellow pre-age knitting as well as the outsole. I don't love that. The whole aged aesthetic, I get it's popular. I get a lot of people like it. I just prefer a more cleaner, more fresh look out of the box. So that's the one nitpick I have. But the black with the burgundy shark teeth, it just looks really nice. I really like the colorway on the shoe. And in terms of materials, it's very nice. A Ma Maniere comes with very good materials most of the time for their collaborations. And they better because they generally do charge more. And this time I think they came through. Very nice nubuck on the upper sole. It feels soft, it feels smooth. If you prefer like a slightly more rougher nubuck, maybe the smoothness of this might not be for you, but it's super soft. The one thing, again, just like colorway, I have to nitpick. I don't know if this belongs as part of like the materials metric, but this yellow netting, this pre-age netting, personally, this is my bias. Not a huge fan. Now, in terms of comfort, I've said this before, the Jordan 5 not only is my favorite silhouette, it's also my favorite in terms of comfort. It just fits my feet really well. The length, the width, the snugness, the padding, the cushioning. It might not be the most advanced cushioning, but I like it. It's perfect for me. Comfort, no complaints from me. In terms of versatility, Jordan 5s, I can see how people would argue that it just still looks too much like a basketball shoe. It is very bulky and it's not as versatile, I guess, in terms of silhouette compared to the Jordan 1, Jordan 3, Jordan 4. However, I think it's versatile. I know I'm biased and I'm trying not to be. I'm trying to be objective, but I think it's a versatile silhouette. And in terms of the versatility of the colorway, an all-black sneaker, I think a white sneaker is still slightly more versatile, but generally an all-black sneaker, still very wearable, especially with the two extra laces they came with. I think those would go really well with a bunch of different clothes. I think this is a versatile colorway. Now, in terms of storytelling, I think that's the biggest strength of A Ma Maniere collaborations. The attention to detail, the storytelling, the short videos they come out with in tandem with the Jordan collaboration. The storytelling is just like immaculate. Every time I review like an A Ma Maniere shoe, I can expect a longer time editing because there's just so many details to go through. From the box itself, from the branding, from the storytelling of the video, from the inspiration. Yeah, you cannot complain about the storytelling of this shoe. A Ma Maniere has rarely had a miss since they started collaborating with Jordan Brand. Even the Jordan 2s I think is super nice. I know people don't love them, but I personally really do. And every time I suspect maybe they're gonna be a bit stale with their next release, they prove me wrong again. When you see it in hand with the materials that they use, with the details and attention to detail that they put into crafting their collaboration, as a sucker for storytelling, they get me every time and they got me again. So that's it. Thanks for watching. Soul Inclined. Let me know what you think of the A Ma Maniere Air Jordan 5 Dusk. Like, subscribe, comment, all the good stuff. And remember. Like, subscribe, comment, all the good stuff. And remember. Tomorrow may never come, so wear your shoes.